transformation.
She developed her eye makeup. She developed the mouth makeup. She created Joan Crawford.
She said to me, you must never go out dressed like sometimes you dress. You must always look your best for your fans.
Joan Crawford.
A smile, free and easy style. You're a loving child, gotta feel it for you.
Much has been written about Marilyn Monroe's childhood in this town. Joan Crawford's childhood would make Marilyn seem like Rebecca of Sunnybrook Farm.
She was born Lucille LeSueur in Texas. Her father deserted the family when she was very young.
This made her come to California, and when she got off the train, there was no one there. She didn't know what to do. She didn't know who to call. And finally, a young man came up and he said, would you by any chance be Lucille LeSueur?
Full-fledged MGM starlet.
In the beginning, they had no one to do makeup or hair or clothes or anything. I mean, the people in her position at that time had to do the best they could. She used to go down to the Ambassador Hotel when they had dances there. And naturally, being a terrific dancer, she attracted the attention.
There were several films which she probably made under the name of Lucille LeSueur.
Joan Crawford. And I said, whoop, sounds like crawfish.
She went to the makeup department and they gave her a case of makeup, and it was just a trial and error thing with her, until she finally arrived at a look that she thought was right.
She developed her eye makeup. She developed the mouth makeup. She created Joan Crawford, much like the name was also created.
She appeared in 18 silent pictures in only 3 years, and then 22-year-old Joan Crawford got her big break in Our Dancing Daughters. Her vivacity and energy seemed to embody what was being called the jazz age.
Some of their very established players whose names were going to carry the picture. Lon Chaney, Charles Ray, John Gilbert, and these increased her box office value. And by the time she finally carried a picture herself, she was a marketable commodity.
In those days, to be a big success in Hollywood, you had to be invited to pick.
Joan had crossed the tracks, but she still felt out of place in Hollywood society. So she made her mother-in-law, Mary Pickford, her model for correct social behavior and copied her every move. Joan Crawford, the former Lucille LeSueur, was on her way to stardom. And she was determined that nothing would stop her. In 1929, panic not only hit Wall Street, it also struck Hollywood. It came in the form of sound. But for Joan, this was a challenge she took in stride. Joan studied great stars like Garbo and Norma Shearer. She learned about camera lenses and the difference that good lighting could make.
Miss Crawford, how much did your rather fraught childhood reemerge in your playing of emotionally disturbed women?
Well, I think I still use certain qualities of it and certain phases of it. It's very helpful to me.
May I have your attention, please? May I have your attention, please? Will the real Slim Shady please stand up? I repeat, will the real Slim Shady please stand up? We're gonna have a problem here.
Do you find, for instance, that some of the hardship that you went through as a child strikes chords, brings memories to you when you're actually formulating a characterization, a part?
What makes you think there aren't hardships when you're grown up?
Again!
It's not fair! You're bigger than I am! It's not fair to win twice!
Ah, but nobody ever said that life was fair, Tina. I'm bigger and I'm faster.
We're gonna have a problem here.
Because I am not one of your fans.
We're gonna have a problem here. I repeat, will the real Slim Shady please stand up?
always beat you.
Act like you never seen a white person before.
This ain't my first time at the rodeo. You forget the press I delivered to Pepsi was my power. I can use it any way I want. It's a sword. It cuts both ways.